Hey, Buns. Well, I think it is inevitable that when you have people being social together, like happens in an MMO, you're gonna have people who clash and like don't get along, and on the other side of things, you'll have people who get along very well indeed. Final Fantasy XIV, as far as I'm aware, is not a dating service. You probably shouldn't play it as one, but at the same time, I am filled with curiosity of situations where people may have actually found their real life partner through the game. So I asked on Twitter, have you ever found love in Final Fantasy XIV? A crush or a romantic relationship with someone you met in game? And if so, do you regret it or are y'all married now? I expect that it will probably run the gamut between like the good, the bad, and the ugly. I met my husband in 2015 one morning while farming Alexandrites before work. 5 years later, married and having two kids. Still playing Final Fantasy XIV. You can tell your kids that they were unspoiled nodes. Found my love doing some ocean fishing. Thanks to COVID, we had enough time to level Fisher and to get in a conversation every 2 hours. The only thing I regret is that I waited too long to chat. Hey, I guess you reeled in a catch. How big was his rod? I'm sorry. Sorry, I'm so sorry. My ex did. Ooh. Ooh. Oh! I didn't meet my wife in 14, but I did get her into playing it. 3 years later, with our desks opposite each other, I got down on one knee and gave her both the eternal bonding ring in game and in real life. Very much still together. That's so cute. What is love? Baby, don't hurt me. Don't hurt me no more. Met in real life, traveled through three countries to meet this person and help them with all sorts of things. Bought them stuff in and out of the game, and after 6 months, no words anymore. They left me without a word, taking away my life in Final Fantasy XIV as they kept the mansion I bought and lots of Gillen items. I've been weak and bought them things they wanted without thinking much because I love to please people and stuff. To my mind, if a friend needed a thing and I can provide it, then I do what I can to help them. Not anymore. So, yeah, I share that story because I would appreciate it a lot if someone with a community as big as yours could send a message to players to not fall in traps like that in the game. Yeah, don't let your kindness be taken advantage of. Too many times, and I regret it all. Whoa. I'm too stoic and neutral to find love. I'm sorry. If you mean the love of crafting, then I rekindled a love of hitting rocks with a pickaxe. Well, that's perfectly fine. I mean, whatever gets your rocks off. Me and my girlfriend met through a mutual friend on 14. It was my first time meeting someone romantically in a game. She helped me through a ton of tough times. 10 out of 10 would recommend. P.S. If this does end up in the video, I love you, Corey. Oh! Well, I gotta put it in there now. Had more heartbreak. Met and enjoyed the company of another player for years. We got the in-game marriage for the items and some fun. I admitted to them a few months to a year later that I was growing a crush on them and got the friend zone instead. Still stings a bit. I know a lot of people do get the in-game marriage just for the items, like to get the mount and stuff, but even if you both agree, oh, this we're just doing this to get the items, there's still kind of this sense like it is a little bit more than that. It's hard to shake that feeling because it's an in-game wedding. Absolutely not. I didn't meet my ex in 14, but that was how we bonded and really got to know each other. It was something we did a lot together. Somehow, divorcing him in game was more satisfying than the actual breakup itself. You can divorce people in game? What, do you take the ring and drop it into the fires of Ifrit's butthole? Not on 14, but one night in 2014, I went to a bar with a friend and she introduced me to him. And while we were talking, we both realized we play 14. We later dated and got married and rated 2 and 3.0 content together, but it didn't work out. Still friends though. Wow, Pepsi Man really was ruthless. He's not just a static killer. I brought my ex-girlfriend into the game and I regret it since she was emotionally abusive. Haven't found love yet, but I can wait. Well, I'm happy to hear that she is an ex and. Yeah, it's better to be alone than to be with somebody who is like that. Back in 2.0, raiding with a group and started spending time with my co-healer. We played together through Realm Reborn and then met at the first fan fest in 2014. We got along real well, kept in touch, started visiting each other. We are now married and have been for 5 years. So y'all were co-healers. Are you telling me You had the hots for each other? Well, I'm not sure if it counts, but I did not expect to fall in love with a hot, monologuing Garlean man and a huge helmet when I got into this game. That's for certain. No regret. Are you talking about such affection? Was not my intention. Jokes aside, I'm single and happy to stay that way. I wouldn't let Gaius hear that. In my dreams, maybe. I can't help but laugh because of your avatar. My now husband and I met through Final Fantasy XIV through a mutual friend. I joined the server and he and I hit it off instantly. I'm American, he's Australian. We've now been married for 3 years and I live in Australia with him. That's amazing that he could play Final Fantasy XIV on an Australian connection. Seriously though, that's wonderful. In Limsa, a Viera struck my heart. I offered her some Realm Reborn Red and some Gil. She responded with 69 gil and the crafting material rubber. Well, you wouldn't need a rubber with 69 gil. I've been trying to farm the striking set from Void Arc for quite a while. I didn't want to subject anyone to the torment of that raid, so I never asked for anyone to come with me until the day I couldn't take it anymore. I sent out a message in the FC chat, and only one person responded. Lo and behold, the final piece I needed dropped at that very run, and I told her that I should have asked her to come sooner if she was going to get my pants to drop that fast. I didn't realize how that sounded till I hit enter. We've been together for 4.5 years now, and I plan to propose once the world isn't quite so crazy anymore. Me and my boyfriend met because one of our friends paid me 250,000 gil to follow him around in game because he feels intimidated when tall men stand behind him. That was over a year ago, and February marks our 1 year anniversary. It seems like he wasn't too terribly intimidated. Yes, big regret though. I've learned that it's really hard to get to know someone well enough to get that involved. It can work out, but exercise extreme caution, folks. Yeah, I think that's a word to the wise in this thread that may get people very excited about possibly meeting someone. For a time, a few years ago, but ultimately my unhappiness and inability to keep relationships intact seeped into online life. I started playing MMOs to distract from real life, but it began mirroring real life pretty quickly. Just goes to show, escape isn't always the best. Yeah, like if your relationships in real life are not working out because you still need to work on yourself, don't expect a relationship within the game to be too much different. The medium is different, but you're still the same person. I didn't know where exactly to start looking, but I knew I didn't want to look in Limsa. Oh. Like, I feel like I just heard everyone in Limsa let out a collective oh. Just a few months back, I began the game and I was focused on raiding, so I knew I wanted a raider waifu. I looked in Kugane every day, searching for happiness. You're searching in Kugane instead. One day, I seen a beautiful bunny lady who was new to 14 like myself and looking to raid. Got married not too long after, and the rest is history. A small piece of advice: always marry your healers. It's like bringing a babysitter into raids, but you're their favorite. Final Fantasy XIV isn't Sword Art Online. Just find love in real life, you weebs. I met my fiance after swapping servers and joining a very small FC. I joined the raid group. She and I started talking randomly, which led to Discord chats, which led to her visiting me in Ohio from California. Then I visited her and her family. Now we have a house together in Nevada and have a wonderful life. So many great things from Final Fantasy XIV. I love seeing love flourish in 14. It's beautiful to see others happy in a game I love dearly. Yeah. However, I've seen way too much of the negative post-breakup drama that happens when things don't work out. People who were thought of as friends take sides and outright harass the ex. It's ugly. I needed help with Eden's verse, Furor Savage, and asked one of my friends if he knew a tank that would be able to help. He brought in my current girlfriend as a tank, and we didn't click immediately. I was a new raider and jumped into the edge more than once as a dragoon, so it was fairly frustrating for her. After a while, I improved a lot, and we started talking about a bunch of things outside of raiding, and eventually decided to start dating each other. I love that she waited for you to get better as a dragoon before she would decide to start dating. There's some motivation for some of you dragoons to improve. I met my now ex-wife in game during Heaven's Ward. I was spamming dungeons to level Dark Knight, and she was a DPS on the same server. We moved in together after a year and a half of dating. Then I screwed up and asked her to marry me. We got married last year and bought a house and got 2 dogs. Well, now she ran off with someone else she met in game, and I'm stuck with the boys in a house I can't afford. So in short, 2 out of 5 wouldn't recommend. I find you gave it 2 points out of five. My heart goes out to you, really. Oh no. The response I got. I'm sorry. I want to share a story that I'm pretty familiar with because it involves two people that are in my static. Zem, our tank, and Morgana, our scholar. Zem wrote here on the tweet saying, "I've been playing 14 for 7 years, and it has given me everything: happiness, friendship, and even love. I met Morgana 4 years ago during Heavensward, and we spent a lot of time together. Decided to try meeting in person. We clicked and been together ever since. I proposed to her during Paris Fan Fest in front of most of our Final Fantasy XIV friends. We are currently planning our real-life wedding. The engagement ring is pink Morganite, both similar to her in-game name, and it's her favorite color." And I can show you actually a picture of the engagement ring. I got a DM from someone who told me that they have a crush on everybody on Crystal Data Center. Apparently, y'all are really sexy over there. Still waiting for Graha to DM me. Well, he probably is trying. He just keeps accidentally DMing other people. It'll take him a few tries. Have you ever had a crush on someone in game or found love in Final Fantasy XIV? How did that go for you? Would you recommend that or would you say never again? Never, never, never. I feel like some people will share this video with someone they're crushing on and they'll be like, "Hey." See what happens. What can happen? I hope it goes well for you if you're in that situation. But if it goes badly, I am not responsible for that. Please don't come running to me like, "Well, Zeppel said I could find the Prince Charming if I was working." You never know what can happen. Please be safe, be careful, use your own judgment. Be really sure you know the person before you decide to go and meet them in real life. Like, do a significant amount of video chatting and make sure you feel like you're very comfortable and not feeling unsafe or don't have any red flags. You know, maybe reach out to your friends, people who care about you, and let them know about this person and get their opinions on the person as well. Buns, thanks for watching. If you like this video, please consider supporting the channel on Patreon or on Twitch. You can also support the channel for free by clicking the subscribe button or by sharing this video with your fellow Warriors of Darkness or your crush if you want. Thanks again so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.